Hi, my name is Mark Kurtz. I'm the machine learning lead here at Neural Magic. Here at Neural Magic, we achieve GPU class performance on commodity CPUs for deep learning. This allows your machine learning teams to be released from the constraints of specialized AI hardware. Using our proprietary algorithms and inference engine, our software allows you to increase performance, save costs and energy, and run bigger models and bigger data, all without sacrificing accuracy or changing your model. Today we're going to be going through our evaluation product. The evaluation product allows you to sample from a set list of models that we've trained on our side, running them through a standard inference engine as well as comparing with ours. So the first one we're going to start with is MobileNetV2. So we'll kick off a benchmark on this. Basically, we're running on 10 CPU cores, batch size 1, and we're going to run it through Onyx runtime first, another CPU implementation, and then compare it with ours now. And basically, as you can see, we get a huge difference in times from Onyx runtime versus ours, to the point of about 19x difference, right? And that all comes from being able to reuse the caches on the CPUs as much as possible by exploiting the deep learning network structure. So whenever we look at GPU comparisons, we can look at a couple popular ones down here that we deployed PyTorch on onto AWS GPUs to benchmark. So we see the T4 here at 204 images per second. And in addition to that, we also deployed our inference engine on C5 instances on AWS to compare as well. So we have different core sizes here and the 18 core coming out the best. But there's a huge difference in price whenever we look at this. The 4-core costing us about 38 cents an hour, and this V100 costing about $3.09 an hour. So that leads to a lot of cost savings as well over here whenever we look at millions of items per dollar, with the GPUs being down here and then our different core instances being up here. Next, we can look at a larger batch size, right? Whenever we're looking at throughput, the GPUs are going to be able to saturate their cores, right? And we can kick that off and run that. And what we can see is that the V100 did very well. It was able to saturate its cores. It got up to about 2,700 images per second. But we can look at our 24 core and we actually beat that at 3,000 images per second. Now we're going to run a ResNet50 model through our engine. ResNet50 is a much more compute intense model. And basically what we can do is actually remove a lot of the compute so that we become memory bound and be able to apply the same memory optimizations that we use on MobileNetV2. The way that we're able to do that is by supporting unstructured sparsity. Whenever we look at this, basically we took ResNet50 and sparsified it such that it got back to 99% of the baseline accuracy on ImageNet. We can also do 100% of the baseline if we wanted to. So we'll go ahead and kick that one off again on 10 CPU cores for real-time inference for batch size 1. We'll run 100 ImageNet data samples through both Onyx runtime and through ours for comparison. And as we can see, we get a huge speed up in terms of other CPU implementations on our 10 cores, right? So we get about a 4.6x speed up over another CPU implementation. And whenever we compare that, we can look at our 10 core. Our 10 core is already beating a T4, right? NVIDIA's new inference chip for real-time latency. And if we go all the way up to 24 cores, then we get significant improvements as well over the top of that. We can also run a larger batch size for this in terms of throughput. And as we can see, the V100 is able to saturate its cores. It gets to about 1,000 images per second, right? But for us, we get to almost 800 images per second on a 24-core instance, and that 24-core instance being much cheaper than that V100, as we can see in the price comparisons over here. So for the V100, we get to about 1.2 million items per dollar. And then for our, even for our 24 core, we get to 1.3 million items per hour. So obviously we can get to significant cost savings as well. And in general, if you're running throughput, it doesn't matter if it takes 50 milliseconds or 100 milliseconds for that batch. What you generally care about, because you're running a lot of them, is how much it costs to run that batch. So as you can see, we're able to get GPU class performance on commodity CPUs at both better performance and a better price point. So if you'd like to learn more or deploy it into your own production system, feel free to reach out and we'd love to hear from you.